Venturi Astrolab Incorporated, known simply as Astrolab, is a company dedicated to designing, building, and operating multi-purpose commercial planetary rovers for human exploration of the Moon and Mars. Located in Hawthorne, California, Astrolab leverages a blend of expertise from terrestrial and planetary robotics, electric vehicles, and human spaceflight. Their team is composed of former engineers from NASA, SpaceX, and JPL. That's the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. With the team's impressive skill set, Astrolab aims to deliver lunar and Martian rovers that are reliable, adaptable, and budget-friendly. Introducing the Astrolab Flex Rover. Astrolab claims that the Flex Rover will be the largest and most capable vehicle to ever operate on the lunar surface. It has a maximum cargo capacity of 1,600 kilos, that's 3,527 pounds, with a volume capacity of 3 cubic meters. While we don't have exact payload capacities for their rivals, such as Intuitive Machines and Lunar Outpost rovers, it does appear to be true that the Flex Rover will indeed have the largest payload of all planned rovers so far. The Flex Rover supports both human and robotic lunar exploration, serving multiple roles from exploration to establishing logistic networks, transporting astronauts, and deploying scientific instruments. One standout feature of the Flex Rover is its hyper-deformable wheels, developed by Venturi. These wheels have been engineered to withstand the harsh conditions of the lunar South Pole. The wheel's outer rim includes springs, allowing the wheel to deform by up to 60 millimeters, that's about 2 inches. This feature provides excellent traction on the moon's soft soil. The rover can climb 30-degree inclines while navigating obstacles of 35 to 40 centimeters in height, that's about 15 inches. The wheels also enable high travel speed, at least in comparison to previous lunar rovers, reaching speeds of up to 20 kilometers an hour. That's 12 miles per hour, which matches the maximum speed of a golf buggy. The wheels can support a vehicle of 2 tons. This includes the payload. Astrolab has secured contracts worth over $160 million from 8 customers for deploying payloads on the moon, with the first mission planned for 2026 on a SpaceX Starship. According to Astrolab, the Flex Rover solves the last mile problem on the moon. While delivering cargo to the moon via rockets is well understood, transporting it to its final destination, especially for large and bulky items like habitation modules, remains unsolved. This is where the Flex Rover, along with other large logistical rovers, steps in. This capability is vital for constructing and maintaining a lunar base. From logistics to habitation, drilling, mining, and excavation, moving heavy and bulky items is essential. The Flex Rover meets NASA's requirements by carrying 2 suited astronauts and features a robotic arm for placing scientific equipment or cargo. It's engineered to endure the extreme temperature fluctuations of the lunar day-night cycle. Additionally, it supports remote operation from Earth, allowing use even when no humans are on the moon. Let's go over the key milestones for Astrolab so far. In March 2022, Astrolab advances lunar mobility with Flex Rover. Astrolab announces the development of the Flexible Logistics and Exploration, or Flex Rover, designed to move both astronauts and cargo across the moon. Apollo-era rovers had a maximum payload capacity of 490 kilos, that's about 1,000 pounds, including the weight of 2 suited astronauts. However, with SpaceX's Starship potentially landing 100 tons of equipment on the moon, larger and more powerful rovers are necessary for cargo transport. This is where the Astrolab Flex Rover plays a pivotal role, with its 1,600 kilo cargo capacity, making the setting up of a substantial moon base possible. Astrolab is developing a multifunctional rover. Flex is engineered to accommodate astronauts riding in the back, and the standing crew interface can be removed to allow for the transportation of larger payloads remotely. For humanity to truly live and operate in a sustainable way off Earth, there needs to exist an efficient and economical transportation network all the way from the launch pad to the ultimate outpost, said Jarrett Matthews, founder and CEO of Astrolab. Currently, there is a gap in the last mile, and Astrolab exists to fill it. The Astrolab team recently conducted tests with a full-scale, fully functional prototype of the Flex Rover in the California desert. They evaluated both crewed and uncrewed operations deploying various large payloads and assess the rover's mobility on challenging terrain. In March 2023, Astrolab has announced an agreement with SpaceX to transport the Flex rover to the Moon using the Starship Launch and Landing System, with a launch scheduled for mid-2026. With a maximum combined mass of over 2 tons, the Flex rover is nearly 3 times heavier than its largest predecessor, the Apollo-era Lunar Roving Vehicle, which had a total combined mass of about 700 kilos. Cargo capacity increases from 490 kilos to 1600 kilos, opening up new possibilities for scientific experiments and commercial operations on the lunar surface. Astrolab plans for the Flex rover to be the first in a fleet of rovers on the lunar surface that will help create a permanent human presence on the Moon and eventually Mars. In November 2023, Astrolab to deploy payloads on the Moon. This rendering shows the Flex rover using its robotic arm to deploy a small plant pod from Interstellar Lab on the lunar surface. This pod is one of the payloads Flex will carry during Mission 1, set to be launched in 2026. Astrolab has secured agreements with 8 customers to use the Flex rover for deploying their payloads on the Moon during Mission 1. These contracts collectively exceed $160 million in value. As part of Mission 1, SpaceX's Starship will transport the Flex rover to the lunar surface, where it will then deploy the payloads for each of its customers. In April 2024, Astrolab awarded contract by NASA. Astrolab has announced that NASA has awarded them, along with their partners Axiom Space and Odyssey Space Research, a contract to further develop their lunar terrain vehicle system. The two other awardees were Intuitive Machines and Lunar Outpost. I've covered Lunar Outpost and their large lunar rover already. Check out that video for details. Astrolab's award is valued at $1.9 billion. Together, the three contract recipients could receive task orders over the next 13 years, potentially amounting to $4.6 billion, with an additional 2 years allowed for service completion. The company has conducted thousands of hours of lab and field testing, resulting in many design improvements. As required by NASA, the Flex rover can transport 2 suited astronauts, features a robotic arm for payload placement, and is designed to withstand the harsh temperatures at the lunar South Pole. Flex can operate remotely from Earth or be driven by astronauts on the Moon. In December 2024, lunar rover vehicles undergo testing at NASA. NASA has completed the first round of testing on 3 commercially owned and developed lunar terrain vehicles, or LTVs, from Intuitive Machines, Lunar Outpost, and Astrolab at NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston. As part of a year-long feasibility study, each company delivered a static mock-up of their vehicle to Johnson by the end of September 2024. Testing started in October and concluded its first phase in December. To simulate the lunar environment where gravity is 1/6 of Earth's, NASA created a simulated low-gravity setting that supports pressurized suited subjects for various reduced gravity tests. NASA's engineering teams conducted tests where suited NASA astronauts and engineers executed tasks, maneuvers, and emergency drills on each rover. These human-in-the-loop tests are vital as they allow crew members to give direct feedback on the ease of use of each rover's design, assess display interfaces and controls, and pinpoint potential safety issues or design flaws. This feedback is then directly communicated to each commercial provider, enabling them to refine their rover designs based on lessons learned. We are excited to have mock-ups from all 3 LTV commercial providers here at Johnson Space Center, said Stephen Munday, LTV project manager. This is the first major test milestone within the Lunar Terrain Vehicle Services contract, and to have actual rovers delivered only 4 months after these companies were awarded is remarkable. Crew members, while wearing NASA's prototype spacesuit, were suspended to simulate the 1/6 gravity of the lunar surface. This setup enabled them to perform tasks outside the rovers, like gathering or storing lunar geology tools, deploying science payloads, and managing cargo, as if they were actually on the Moon. While wearing the Axiom Space's pressurized spacesuit, teams assessed the difficulty crew members had in moving in and out of the rovers, navigating the crew compartment, and interacting with display interfaces and hand controls through thick gloves. Testing also included emergency drills, where engineers practice rescuing an incapacitated crew member. As mandated by NASA, each rover's design must allow an astronaut to single-handedly rescue their fellow crew members in case of an emergency. Upcoming events. The Astrolab Flex Rover is scheduled to go to the moon under the Artemis program. Although Astrolab's website suggests a 2026 launch, this date remains uncertain due to ongoing delays in the Artemis program and changes following the NASA administrator transition. It's challenging to pinpoint exact dates for moon missions at this point. We will just have to wait and see what happens to the Artemis program and commercial space plans in general. 2025 promises to be an exciting year in space exploration. We'll be here to bring you all the latest updates on space startups from the United States, Europe, Asia, and around the world. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.